perspective of faciality structures in the city and use that kind of pervading public space everywhere in the city. So I think what is fascinating about this envelope is that it is one of the, I would say, the biggest act in terms of political agency that we can use for this envelope is precisely the fact that this is what details in the city, what is the border between the open public space and the internal public space. For example, here there is no differentiation, but you can see that in Barcelona, in more traditional city structures, you have the flat vertical envelopes, the limits, and set the demarcates private and public domains from each other. So that's first potential. Second potential is that, as opposed to the two previous typologies, here the scheme has very strict and very important functions as a climatic and environmental device, and at the same time as an expressive and representational device. So as opposed to the previous case where there was a kind of demand of on the envelope of presence, expression, representation, and not so much demand in terms of thermal performance, for example. In this case, those two constraints are set sometimes against each other. And I think that is probably also quite interesting as a political problem. There is a kind of whole history of these patterns that wrap around the flat vertical envelope, some of them insisting in the cellular nature of the society, the community that inhabits, then sometimes insisting in the capacity of a certain civilization to produce things in a certain way, to kind of even out differences. More lately, again, this tendency towards differentiation of the flat vertical envelope as a kind of expression of that desire that I think most cultures today have to become integrative, to become capable of bringing in people from different cultures, from different sources, ethnic, gender, etc., etc. I always talk about issues that are, when I talk about this dichotomy between consistency, social consistency, and cultural consistency, and differentiation, I always like to refer to the French ban on religious symbols in schools, or the project of Britishness in the UK, where as opposed to the kind of multicultural desires that cultures had in the 70s, we now are living again a certain need to create arguments of consistency across cultures. And so after a period in which many of these envelopes have been differentiated, for example, in the way we are seeing here, almost a kind of artificially or stereographically to explain we live in multiple cultures and so on and so forth, I would like to explain a project that we finished in Madrid also a few years ago for a social housing block that had to occupy a certain proportion that we had the idea that we managed to fit all the units within the height that was allowed and in one side of the site that we were given to be able to provide views into two open spaces. So that led us into a very deep block that then we thought it could be, if it was social housing, fully raised, so that we will have again a very transparent relationship between the inside and the outside of the building. By making the building very compact, we were able to lower the construction cost enough to be able to afford this, but because we are in Madrid and this was east-west oriented, we had to provide the secondary scheme that we used to make terraces for every one of the units. I think the plans are irrelevant, except that what is interesting is that all the buildings are through, all the units are through units, which means they have natural ventilation, they almost have a double aspect. And this is basically this invention of a folding screen made out of bamboo, which is a very typical garden material in Madrid. But this is how the building works. Now, what I'm interested in this is precisely the fact that the scheme, in this case, is acting both as a kind of environmental device that selects views and decides to protect, to make the terraces, the apartments more private, but at the same time acts as a kind of solar shading device to protect and create some kind of buffer zone around the building, but at the same time also creates that differentiated pattern that, that probably talks or tries or tends to talk also about representing the community as a kind of varied community, as an integrative community. So there is a kind of double agenda of this envelope of being at the same time expressive of certain political and social contents and also performing certain environmental performance. The other project that we brought from this category is an office complex that we are doing in the city of London. It's currently on hold, and most of these commercial projects in this location here. I'm not going to, I need to go very quickly because otherwise I'm never going to make it to the end of the lecture. So, because of a number of reasons, the buildings are three office blocks, central core, very conventional, but that are chiseled in order to save air and light rise to the surrounding fabric, but they are also limited by some kind of view corridors affecting the side, so they have this kind of crystalline geometry almost by default. You know, we exaggerated it at some point with self-shading tilts and open tilts to play with the orientation of the buildings to the sun. I think it's not so important. You can see it's quite a conventional complex of three central core office buildings around the central atrium. Well, I think what is interesting about this this project is that once we decided they were crystalline objects, jewels, obviously we needed to use glass. Glass is not a very sustainable material, despite the fact that in this case the proportion, the aspect ratio, the facade ratios were pretty good, and we could easily pass the part. And we needed to have some system of solar shade incorporated, and we decided, we asked our consultants to give us a kind of cumulative effect of solar shading through the year on these forms, and we use those determinations that are differential. The buildings look the same from they are actually very different, they have different orientations. And so what we did was to study again a series of tiles that would be treated with certain density and a certain pattern, but there is always a discrete number of tiles. And that by combining those tiles, we can provide to different phases of the building different degrees of solar shading. So these are some tests of those decorations, but at the same as being